I used to tell people that I went to school in the middle of the cornfield.
We used to have tractor day at Center Grove High School, which they definitely do not have that now.
You know, it's interesting because we were really at the cusp of a growing school. We were already one of the largest schools in the area when I was there.
But just the school environment in terms of the use of technology and really that being key is in education, don't tell anybody. We used to be able to sneak out at lunchtime out to our cars in the parking lot, and that doesn't happen anymore, I bet.
Favorite memory, I was a cheerleader, so always the football games and the basketball games were the most fun. Everybody was involved, the dancing, the singing, everything, so it was a great time with that.
When we would go to the ball games, we would pitch in money so somebody could drive their car. Gasoline was 18 to 20 cents a gallon, and if you pitched in a dime or 15 cents, get three or four of your classmates to do that, you could drive your car all night.
One of the places that on date night would be the Meridian Drive-In, which is up at the corner of Fairview and 135. It's now where Kroger's. But that, for many of us, was fond memories of trying to park on the back row at the drive-in.
We cruised the square at Franklin, and that is a totally foreign concept to kids nowadays, but it is literally what it sounds like. We would get in a car, and we would drive around and around and around the square to see who else was also out driving around and around the square.
To the TP up in Indianapolis, we thought we were real big shots going up there, being from the country.
The most popular thing after football games was you went to Arby's or Steak and Shake, and everybody went there. Then there's always usually drama that followed, so.
The friends that I had then are pretty much my best friends still now, so definitely the best memory could be the friends I created at Center Grove.
When you and your friends hung out, what did you guys do?
My grandmother married somebody that was out here, and my dad went to Center Grove. And I'm not sure what year he graduated, but he did graduate. He was probably the first African American or black or whatever to graduate from Center Grove. And then he stayed out here, and then we all just graduated, all eight of us kids. Mama did not graduate from high school. So she said, all of my children are going to graduate. And so we all did.
We all got to vote about what we thought the future held for our classmates, and I was actually voted most likely to become a judge.
When our whole class went on a senior field trip, we were the first class to fly, and we went to New York, and then we went to Washington, D.C., and went to the museums, and I think what I remember the most is that our whole class was there.
And my dad was president of school board when I graduated, so that was a fun, interesting thing. He got to hand me my diploma when I walked across stage.
I don't know that there was a whole lot going on in 89. I think the Berlin Wall fell.
It was our sophomore year when 9/11 happened, and the rest of the day in classes was you were watching the news and watching the TV. And
in our senior year in November, when President John Kennedy was killed, that year, as a part of the high school annual, we actually dedicated the annual to the President Kennedy. And if you look back at the 1964 annual opening page, there's a picture of American flag at half staff with a dedication of to those who much is given, much is required.
You never really meet a stranger at Center Grove. Everybody is very friendly, down to earth. You can talk to anybody. So that has definitely stayed the same.
From an academic standpoint, it's still one of the top schools in the state. And we want to stay there, and we want to get better.
Because, you know, back then, if you got in trouble at school, then you got in trouble at home. Because it definitely takes a village to raise a child. And Center Grove was kind of a village, and they helped take care of everybody.